That boldness, that fearlessness, that tremendous love. He was born for the good of men. Others may see God. Others may see truth for themselves. He didn't even care to seek the truth for himself. He sought out truth because people were in misery. How can he be helpful to others was his concern. Throughout his life, he didn't even have a thought for himself. Surely, he was the greatest man in the world. These are the words of Swami Vivekananda on Gautama the Buddha. Namaste, dear friends. Today, on this Vaishakha Purnima, we are celebrating the 2565th Buddha Purnima. Born as a prince with not just a silver spoon, perhaps with a golden spoon, with richness and luxury all around. When he happened to encounter the other side of life, he got to realize the temporariness of the life. With sickness, old age, and death being that which is inevitable in life. And when Siddhartha happened to see all those, he understood that this life is temporary and there is something which is beyond this bodily, mundane, materialistic life. And he just left everything, the home, his wife, the child, the princely richness, and attained the Vairagya. And as a seeker, as a jignasu, as a bodhisattva, he just stepped out and then went to Bodhagaya from Lumbini, the place where he was born. And as we all know, sitting under the Bodhi Vriksha, after enough of contemplation, the tapas, the penance, that he attained enlightenment, became Buddha. In our spiritual system, we always had a balance between knowing the Jnana Kanda and doing the Karma Kanda. At times when the doing became more and the knowing part was almost forsaken, Buddha came at the right time and tried to bring a balance between the knowing and the doing. But this doing was not just a mechanical doing, but a heartful doing of the Prema Marga, the Karuna Marga, the Ahimsa Marga that he brought. In fact, Buddha is considered to be an incarnation of Lord Vishnu as per Srimad Bhagavatam and other Bhakti scriptures. In this holy land, whenever there was a need for bringing the righteousness again and re-establishing it, the divine descent is what we feel. And accordingly, certainly Buddha was a great son of Bharata who brought back the divine glories of our spiritual heritage. Not just in India, but from Bharat, he took it to various parts of the country through his teachings, through his disciples, through his Buddha Sangha. One of the major important principle of the Buddha Dharma is Ahimsa, Ahimsa Paramo Dharmaha. We see this wonderful incident which happens in Buddha's life, which we all have heard. Just to recollect, Anguliyamalaka. Anguliyamalaka was a person, a dacoit, who had an ambition, a wicked ambition of, you know, cutting the thumbs of at least 1,000 people with the rings and then making a mala and then wearing it. And almost it is said that he succeeded a lot, and then that particular day he did not get anybody to, you know, chop their finger off and then put it in his mala, the garland. So he goes and catches hold of his own mother, his own biological mother, the Mata, who should be revered as the god, and then he tries to cut off her finger. It is then when Buddha, who sees it, comes and stops him, saying, "What do you do? She's your mother." "Yes, so what? She's my mother. I'm cutting her finger. How does this disturb you?" Then Buddha says, "Your mother is my mother as well. I can't, you know, let you to cut." So that feeling of Buddha's, that universal love of feeling the mother in his mother as his own mother, touched and transformed Anguliyamalaka. And he became a transformed person in the presence of Buddha the enlightened. That's what Patanjali says in the Patanjali Yoga Sutra, Ahimsa Pratishtayam Tatsanidho Vairatyagaha. In the presence of one who is established in the non-violence virtue of Ahimsa, even others automatically give away the enmity. Anguliyamalaka's story brings us this wonderful message, my dear friends, of the Patanjali Yoga Sutra as well. In today's scenario, the other incident I would like to quote is the story about a lady who lost her beloved son and she wanted him back to life. She got to know Buddha is enlightened and he had lot of miraculous powers, the siddhis. He's a yogi and therefore he can bring back the dead son to life. So she takes the boy to Buddha's place and then she cries, Buddha, can you please bring my son back to life? And Buddha gives her a task of going to the house of at least one person where there is no death which has happened so far and bring a handful of rice for his bhiksha and then he can bring the son back to life. So this lady goes around the village to house to see, you know, whether there is any house where there is no death which has happened. And to her shock, nobody could give her the rice, the handful of rice, because every house, one way or other, death has happened. Death is inevitable. Jatasya drivo mrityuhu, she realizes and then comes back. So this abhinivesha, again a klesha which Patanjali talks about, Buddha teaches a lesson that death is inevitable. We all have to face it. But how we live is more important. It teaches the right way of living through the Ashta Sopana, the eightfold path that he teaches, the right view or the right understanding, the right thoughts, the right speech, the right conduct, the right livelihood, the right efforts, the right mindfulness, and last, the right contemplation or the meditation are the eight steps of rightful living which Buddha had taught, my dear friends. And today, in the field of yoga, it could be, or meditation, the influence of Buddha's teachings are so much inevitable that in the form of Vipassana Marga or the Anapanasati, Vipassana is nothing but just to be, you know, mindful of, you know, taking things as they are. That acceptance is what it is all about, which is Buddha's teaching, and also the mindfulness which comes to us, and eventually through the breath also that you can bring a control of the mind is what is Anapanasati meditation, which is one of the Buddhistic teaching. So much is there for us to learn from Buddha, and the three wonderful principles that Buddhism took to the entire world at large was Buddham Sharanam Gacchami, Dharmam Sharanam Gacchami, Sangam Sharanam Gacchami. What are the three things? The Guru, the enlightened Buddha, who was a Bodhisattva, the seeker, the Jignasu, who became the Buddha. So may we seek refuge under the Guru, and may we seek the refuge, take the shelter of his teachings, the Dharma. Right? So Buddha's teachings are the Dharma, which later formed the wonderful text of Dhammapada. And so Dharmam Charanam Gacchami, we have to go and seek the shelter at the Dharma, the teachings of Buddha. And finally the Sangha, the association of the holy people, Satsangha, is what the monkhood, the brotherhood of the Buddhist followers, which he said, which we can take it as a right association of the right people, the Sangha, which is very important. So with this message of Buddha, Dharma and Sangha, may we remember all these wonderful teachings what Buddha, the enlightened, has given us on this Buddha Purnima. I wish each one of you on behalf of Disha Bharat and all of us here, enlightened Buddha Purnima. May we all try to take up these teachings of Buddha and bring out the Bodhisattva in us and make him to become a Buddha.